Welcome, everyone, to the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by the talented analyst tandem of Greg Anthony and Chris Webber. David Aldridge is on our sideline. It's the Sacramento Kings facing the New York Knicks. The big story here is the return of Rudy Gay, who had been sidelined with an injury.
Yeah, and Kevin, it's good to be here for his first game back. And I'll tell you, any fears they had about this injury having a bit of an ill effect on the team were swept aside pretty quickly when they began to really play great without it. I mean, they really didn't suffer nearly as much in his absence as most would expect.
Yeah, a number of his teammates rising to the challenge, pitching in, and an experience that could make this team stronger than it was before.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. On the court right now for the Kings, we've got DeMarcus Cousins. Collison is out there with Chalmers. And there's Anthony Tolliver. And it's Gay in at the small forward position. Rose with the ball. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game. Cousins, the pass to Tolliver. To the middle. And there's Gay. That's good on the assist by Tolliver. And when you look at these teams, both very tough on the glass.
Oh, yeah. High effort, high energy. They sharpen their elbows for this one. This is an inside battle.
Yes. Now, here's Porzingis. He's coming off a 13-point game against Minnesota.
And when Lee has the ball there, it's over. He's going up for the throwdown every time.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, I was able to speak with Jeff Hornacek for just a minute. It's the first matchup of the season against this team, and he knows that they have great shot blocking. But he did say we've got to remain aggressive and continue to attack. Put the bigs in high pick-and-roll situations and shoot the jumper with confidence. They feel that's the key, Kevin.
Terrific, Dave. Thanks. They put a lot of thought into how they're going to match up against the opposing defense guys.
And so they should, because that's what it's going to take. This is such a tough D to break down. They're going to have to play a smart, smart game offensively.
You're exactly right. This is a defense that can really rattle you, frustrate you. You have to just try to be efficient in your approach. Maintain your pool.
Here's Gay, following the basket by Kristaps Porzingis. Gay, count that one.
Their offense looks extremely fluid right now. Four makes on all four shots.
The Kings shooting their first free throw of the game right now. Free throw good from Gay.
And when it comes to athletic small forwards, Gay is the cream of the crop. An aggressive player whose reach really helps him on both offense and defense.
Porzingis again.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
Kings have gone 4-of-4 to start. So a nice offensive rhythm to start here. Three from Gay. It's rebounded by New York. Coming off that loss against the Timberwolves.
And you know what? A shame that either team had to lose that game, because you had to be proud of the way they battled in it.
Gut-wrenching. You put that much energy into a game, that much passion into a game, catch up, sending it to OT. You want to come away with the win.
This team is rolling right now. Still haven't missed a shot.
No one near him. Sacramento gets it back. And Cousins kicks to Collison. Gay dishes to Cousins. A second chance effort. And it's good on the way in. And Kings head coach Dave Yeager spent 9 seasons coaching in Memphis, 3 as the head coach, and helped them establish one of the top defensive reputations in the league.
Well, even before he took over as head coach in Memphis, he was a defensive coordinator of sorts, the architect of their defense from 2010 on. Just as important as his schemes, though, the Grizz always played hard for him. Grit and grind, that's what the Kings need.
We've seen the lead change hands quite a bit in this one.
And guys, I think each team knows they can win this game, just a matter who can catch that momentum.
Now here's Anthony, looking for his first basket still in this one. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
New York shooting their first free throws here tonight.
And as a team, really just middle of the pack in terms of their percentage from the line at about 76.
Sacramento making a switch here. Aflalo's checked in. Cousins against Noah. And then Cousins with the dunk.
Whenever Cousins get that close to the basket, it's game over for the D. He is such a forceful presence, especially when he's dunking.
The Knicks have gotten 6 or 7 shots to fall in the first quarter. They're off and running. Jennings kicks to Anthony. It's back to Jennings. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. Anthony's got 3 assists now in this one.
Well, if you like offense, that's what you're getting here early on.
Well, both teams are continuing to move the ball and get outstanding looks at the basket as they quickly get out the gates.
Out of bounds, Kings ball as Sacramento keeps possession. Thomas checked in for Carmelo Anthony. A follow the pass to Gay. Down low. Noah with the block. Shot clock at 5. A fader. Got a piece of it.
I'm not sure if he was trying to show off or what, but he made an easy shot 10 times more difficult by fading away.
Here's Kuzminskis. Offline with his 3. For Sacramento, they've gone 7 of 11 from the field to begin the game. Here's Jennings. Here's Thomas. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. It's going to be on Rudy Gay.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
The Knicks shooting their 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the night. And everyone knows that the Knicks have been committed to the triangle offense. Not the easiest offense to run or learn, Greg Anthony, but they are staying with it.
And I think for the foreseeable future, that is going to be the plan. I mean, their roster can work with it, but it hasn't been easy thus far. You wonder if the offense has simply fallen out of favor due to the up-tempo nature of the modern NBA.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. Here's Tolliver. The Kings have shot just 1 free throw early, 1 for 1 in the game.
And the season numbers for them at the line thus far are really poor, something I'm sure they are making a point of emphasizing.
Good on the 2nd free throw. The Knicks with the lead. Jennings dishes to Holiday. Outside Jennings. And Holiday kicks it to Noah. That one's not going to go. And it's the Kings taking it the other way. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with Boston.
You know, you hate to use this word, but I really felt like it was a sorry effort that they put forth on the defensive side.
They weren't hustling at all. They weren't rotating, basically letting that offense do anything it wanted to.
Now here's Jennings. He averages a bit over 6 points a game. Noah the screen. Jennings passes to Holiday. From deep. No good there. A nice first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far. Kings lead by 1. And we'll be back with you for the start. And catching up with Porzingis, he spoke.
Definitely wasn't a good feeling when you get booed at the Jazz.
Yeah, Knicks fans really gave it to Porzingis, and most of them hadn't even seen him play.
And it was unfair, but that's sports. You know, who knows, maybe it motivated him to prove people wrong. He's been tougher than a lot of people thought, and that's, you know, you got to tip your hat to him.
Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the 2nd quarter going back here. And looking at what we've seen from Sacramento so far, guys, what do you think?
You know what? They're dominating on the backboard. They have controlled the paint thus far.
Yeah, they came in on a mission. Absolutely flying around the rim. Their relentlessness has been unmatched.
On the court for the Kings as the 2nd quarter gets underway. Rudy Gay is out there with Anthony Tolliver. Then there's DeMarcus Cousins. Then there's Chalmers. And it's Temple in at the shooting guard position. And the Knicks making a change here. Porzingis has checked in. There's Jennings with the 3. Rebound by the Kings. Gay's got his 3rd rebound tonight. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. Well, we know the given here, the X's and O's of coaching, Chris, the strategy that's used by all staffs and all head coaches. But coaching is a lot of motivating your players to give it their all. And when you look at all the different coaches around the league, which coaches do you think are the best at motivating?
Well, you know, that's hard to answer. You really have to play with these guys. That's an intimate type question. But from where I'm standing, I would definitely think from a motivating point of view, I'd have to go with Doc Rivers. He just seems to know how to communicate to his players, how to get them to fight down to the last drop, and that's what you want to coach.
Well said. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Rhodes. And where have the shots been coming from tonight? Here's a look, broken down by paint, mid-range, and three-point shot attempt so far for the Kings.
And you see not a lot of corner threes. The defense doing a good job of closing out and denying those shorter distance triples. That's what the smart teams have to do.
The Kings leading. Here's Chalmers. Makes it off the glass. Chalmers has got 6 points. New York's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Chalmers against Rose. Pass to Anthony. Score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt.
So versatile. Always pushing the action offensively.
Chalmers dishes to Cousins. Back to Chalmers. Let's it go with a three. It's rebounded by Noah.
After nailing an outside jumper during the first quarter, he can't seem to build off of it in this second.
Lee kicks to Anthony. Anthony missing again. For Sacramento, they've gone 2-4 shooting the ball here in the second. And that one's goodbye, Gay.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
And they need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Ball's knocked loose. Lee passes to Anthony. And again, it's New York. Timeout is called. First of the game for Sacramento. And the one thing you love about Courtney Lee is just how complete a player he is, Chris, at that shooting guard position.
Well, as Courtney Lee once said, effort takes, no talent. Meaning you can always give effort when you're on the court, and it shows. This quote embodies how he plays defense and how he attacks the rim and doesn't settle for anything.
Kyle O'Quinn, he's checked in for the Knicks. And throughout the years, one thing that the Kings, Chris, have done well as a franchise is put together an exciting team.
And as you said, that applies to good or bad. From the white chocolate days with my man Jay Will dazzling the fans to the Mitch Richmond team, the Kings have always been fun to watch. Part of it is that the franchises always seem to prefer playing an up-tempo style of basketball.
Collison kicks to Cousins. And Cousins throws it down.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury.
And he rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish. Knicks trail by 6. Left side, Rose. Porzingis passes to O'Quinn. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Cousins has got 3 rebounds now in this one. No good from Caspi. Knicks have gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Shots good by Anthony.
He's nailing a lot of his attempts right now. This might end up being a big game.
Collison with it. He's picked up by Lee. Here's Temple. And he's good on the 3-ball. Knicks have gotten a little under 50% of their second quarter shots to find the mark. 4 of 9 all told. Rose softly drops in the floater. Rose has got 7 points.
And the defense tried to slow him down, but Derrick Rose just a handful when he gets around the rim.
Collison dishes to Casper. Here's Cauley Stein. And that's out of bounds. Sacramento will retain possession. Now let's have a look at the teams that have had the quickest hands in the NBA during the past month. The Kings in second.
What a month they've had defensively. I mean, they've really gotten after it on that end of the floor.
stolen by O'Quinn. Pushing it up, no one back to stop him. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, he'll shoot two. It's on Darren Collison.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
New York shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game. Sacramento making some changes. Kufis checked in for Cousins. This year comes in for Cauley Stein. And it's a follow in for Garrett Temple. Took him no time at all on that one. Kufis has got his first basket.
Terrific ball movement. No surprise it leads to a good shot.
Jennings kicks to Holiday. Here's the screen. Feeds it to O'Quinn. Kufis with the block. And they're pushing it up. And Caspi has it in the corner. And another three for Sacramento.
Smooth looking catch and shoot jumper from Caspi. If the D is playing off of him, he loves making them look foolish.
And that's his fourth foul. And we're not even at halftime. That is going to limit his playing time and his aggressiveness the rest of the game. And, you know, it's been a long time coming to be able to say this, but I'm starting to sense some hope and optimism with this Knicks basketball team. I mean, they're in a good spot financially. They're going to have flexibility in terms of filling out that roster. And then you've got a core of young talent that is exciting the fan base and which you can build around.
Garrett Temple has checked in for the Kings. O'Quinn, the pass to Kuzminski. It's good for his second make. He's made two or three so far.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
And for the Knicks and their positive outlook, when New York has a Knicks team that they love, that can capture the hearts of the entire city.
And you have some of the most diehard fans in the world wearing Knicks colors, no doubt about it. You can see the team also has improved the ball movement and the team play in the last couple seasons. Knicks are starting to become a team that is exciting to watch, win or lose.
Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. And it's by O'Quinn. Here's Kuzminski. Now Jennings. Got it up. What a play. Simply cranes it in at the buck. And a pretty tight Lincoln.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here once again. A pretty close game for the Kings throughout the first quarter. Their largest deficit of the period was just 4 points. They were right there within shouting distance the entire time. The second quarter was dead even in terms of their scoring output from both. And it's just about time now for the third quarter to...
Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break in halftime. We'll see now if one can pull out away here in the third. You look at DeMarcus Cousins in this game, he has been everywhere.
And he really just broke out the entire arsenal of post moves there in that first half.
Yeah, great activity in the painted area. Lots of energy. Looking to score almost every time he got the ball.
Porzingis is the four with O'Quinn at the five. Lee out there with Derrick Rose. And it's Anthony in at the small four. So that's who's on the floor for the Knicks. Outside Rose. Anthony dishes to Lee. Back to Anthony. Some nice passing by New York here. Rose. That one falls coming off Anthony's feet. Rose has got nine.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
And watching Melo, you can just see how his game has grown since when he came into the league. I mean, still as great a scorer as you're going to find, but he's doing so much now in terms of his passing and his defense. I mean, visibly much more of an impact on the floor in other facets. And I think that's a credit to his maturation and the reason why there's some optimism for the Knicks.
Here's Porzingis, and he converts the layup. He's got six.
And that was the play to make. Rose making the right read.
Dishes to Kufis. Gay outside. The feed to Temple. Here's the screen. Just four to shoot. Stolen by O'Quinn. And there's a call on Garrett Temple. That is his first foul of the game. Joakim Noah is checked in for New York. Lee kicks to Rose. And stolen by Kufis. Here's the break. Rose with the rebound.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
A follow, that's good.
He's not the most consistent threat from long range, Kevin, but the defense still needs to play him honest, rotate over and contest.
Lee kicks to Anthony. Kufis with the block. Gay with no one around. Rebounded by Anthony.
The defense there got away with a major lapse.
Lee outside. And there's the pass to Porzingis. Bank shot. No good. Kings leading now by five. Kufis the pass to Temple. The tray. And it's Kufis missing. For New York, they've gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Here's Noah. That one falls, coming off Anthony's feet. Anthony's got 5 assists tonight.
Not a good idea to let him get such good position in the paint.
Man, this defense has to be more aware out there. Once he's established like that, it's game over.
And out of bounds as the Knicks gain possession.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
For the Knicks, Lance Thomas, he's checked in for Anthony. Justin Holiday comes in for Courtney Lee. And it's Jennings in for Derrick Rose. And McLemore, he's checked in for the Kings. Well, the league, Chris, as you know, looking to cut down on the hack-a-shack, the hack-a-whoever intentional fouling down the stretch. Do you like those changes?
Well, I like the fact that the NBA came together and tried to find a remedy for something that they did not want to be a problem for our fans, and that's you know, being bored to death, watch guys break free throws that can't shoot free throws. I don't like the fact, though, that it does let guys off the hook that should be able to shoot free throws, and I don't like the fact that it hides a weakness, but I do like the fact that the NBA came together. I do think it'll address that problem, but the basic problem or the basic solution is kids, you know. Free throws are the easiest part of the game to practice. Literally, the easiest. Go out there and practice your free throws so you can go out there and get and ones and get a three-pointer the old traditional way.
Great points. And there's the call on Garrett Temple. That'll be his second foul of the game. So both teams making some changes here. Chris, you're a Detroit product through and through. Grew up in the area and played for the University of Michigan. Did growing up in Detroit impact at all how you played the game?
Oh, man, definitely. You know, growing up on the west side of Detroit, I just, you know, everybody in Detroit were Pistons fans. So, number one, that influenced me a big time. It's funny. Isaiah was my favorite player, and after he won the MVP a couple of times, he would always say, "Hi, Mom. Hey, Mom. Hi, Mom." So that's why after every game, I actually did it. It was influenced that way. And Chuck Daly, he was a mentor to me. He knew me in high school, but as I grew older, his relationship meant a lot to me. So I can't thank, you know, Isaiah and Rick Mahorn. You know, I met those guys in high school. I can't thank them enough for their positive influence on me. Guys like John Sally and of course, Joe Dumars. So played for other teams, but as a fan, I always grew up a Pistons fan.
Like that. Noah. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. And G.A., after being such a fixture in the city of Chicago and for so long, Joakim Noah, signing with his hometown team, the Knicks, in the last offseason, a bit of a bittersweet end of his time with the Chicago Bulls. A lot of moving parts in his time with Chicago.
Yeah, and, you know, his playing time had dwindled, and it was just, I think, in everyone's best interest for him to move on. It's a great fit in New York, both with the team and the pulse of the city. Clearly was still valued highly around the league, as it took a sizable contract to put him in that Knick uniform.
Kyle O'Quinn is checked in for Noah. Here's O'Quinn. Kufis with the block. Barnes outside. Shot from the wing. And the rebound goes to the Knicks. 5 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. It's good. He's got 8.
Hey guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
And McLemore kicks to Aflalo. Barnes outside. He dishes it to Kufis. On its way from a follow for 2, can't connect. It's a tie game in New York, and we'll have the start of... All right, the fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. The Knicks shooting fantastically in this game, 62% from the floor. And a look at the 5 for the Kings to start the fourth. Collison is out there with a flow. Then it's Matt Barnes. Then there's Kufis. And it's Cauley Stein in at the 4.
Now that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active and be ready as soon as the shot goes up.
And that one falls for O'Quinn. The Kings trail by 3. Collison kicks to Barnes. And a follow wide open. He shoots. Buries it from 3-point range.
And this has really been a well-played game up to this point. And you know what? I bet it stays that way until the end.
Well, it's really been a tight contest. No reason to believe it won't be until the final buzzer.
There's the dish to Cauley Stein. Follow against Lee. The kick out to Collison. Misses the 3. And Willie Cauley Stein gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
And the Knicks making a change here. Noah's checked in. The Kings also with the sub. LeBissiere is checked in for Cauley Stein. Now off the inbound, and the layup is good. And the Knicks lead by 2.
And the D not really doing its job there. A little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint.
Barnes dishes to Kufis. Can't hit that one. And New York the other way now. They get to take on the Heat at Miami after this one. That will be a getaway game for them. A one-game road trip. It's stolen by LeBissiere. And now Sacramento on the break. He doesn't hit that one. Great D that time from Jennings. Knicks have gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. New York moving it around. Here's Anthony. And good. Got the English that time as it falls. Anthony's got the lead up to 4 now for the Knicks. Collison kicks to Aflalo. From 11 feet away. And there's LeBissiere. That's good on the assist by Aflalo.
Oh, I like seeing LeBissiere expand his range, looking solid from the mid-range.
Lee passes to Kuzminskas, and it's Lee penetrating, takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from the paint.
Deflects the pass. It's 2-on-1. Here's Anthony. Oh, and the jam by Anthony.
And guys got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
And how about the explosiveness he shows, going from the offensive to the defensive end in a blink.
And up the court come the Kings on the break. Collison's got the ball.
And the 6'1", 175-pound Collison is a vital part of this team. A speedy point guard who can get hot in a hurry.
Now, what you have to like about Derek Collison is the fact that he gives you a little bit of everything from the point guard position. He can shoot it from deep. He can attack the basket depending on what the defender gives him. He acts as a true facilitator for the rest of the team when he's manning the point guard.
Porzingis is checked in for New York. Rose comes in for Brandon Jennings. The Kings trail by four. Down low. Here's Gay outside. Connects from three-point range. And Chris, with Collison, as you said, he is a jack of all trades as a floor general.
Well, a lot of it is that Collison knows what he can and can't do and plays within himself. Always plays to the tempo of the game.
Anthony kicks the lead. Count the basket.
And although he's not the star player, he does not shrink away in moments like this. He is more than happy taking the big shot.
Collison dishes to Gay. He kicks it to Tolliver. Back to Gay. Six to shoot. Chalmers passes to Cousins. Good. Chalmers with the assist that time. 13 points for DeMarcus Cousins.
Oh, man. And in these moments, Cousins is ready to take these shots. He does not shy away from the big moment.
And now the Kings fast break. Here's Tolliver. Finishes the break with a slam. And guys, here in the fourth quarter, still a close game.
Instant classic, fellas. This one could come right down to the last shot.
Screen by Porzingis, and Mario Chalmers gets the whistle that time. That'll be his second foul of the game. There's 1:54 left in the game. Here's Noah. Kicks it to Rose. Shot clock at six. A wide open look here for Porzingis. And again, New York with the triple.
And those are the types of shots down the stretch that win you ball game.
A drive by Collison. Passes it to Chalmers. Outside Collison. Back to Chalmers. And the jam by Rudy Gay.
Just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball. And the replay, of course, presented by Kia. What a play.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
He hits the first one, and that gives them the lead. Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one.
An uneven trip to the line, but they do come away up by one.
And Cousins kicks to Gay. Back to Cousins. Three-pointer. Another three for Sacramento.
Oh, what a huge basket from Cousins. He knows he's the number one option on offense when the game is on the line.
Rose dishes to Carmelo. And it's Gay with the rebound. Sacramento's gone 3 of 4 from downtown here in the fourth. Collison, the pass to Cousins. Gay against Anthony. Back to Cousins. A three. It's good from beyond the arc.
And they clearly are just destroying this group right now from the three-point line.
They're taking any look they can get from there. Just making it rain from the perimeter right now.
Kyle O'Quinn is checked in for Noah. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Jeff Hornacek said to his team. He said, we've got to pick it up right here, right now. If we're going to win this game, we have to take control. This is the time. Kevin.
Thank you, David.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Here's Chalmers. The shot's good. Collison making the play. Now it's a 7-point Sacramento lead.
And they can up the ante a little bit there after that basket.
I mean, they seem to gain more energy after each made bucket. Let's see if they try to really bust it open here.
Let's go! Jennings kicks to Holiday. But they recover it. Thomas, it's in! A Oh, and that cuts the lead to just five.
Ooh, shaky possession, but somehow he gets the shot to fall.
And an intentional foul right there. Collison dishes to Chalmers. And that's an intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that increases their lead to six. Second one is good, being both at the line, and it's a 7-point game. New York calls timeout. They're losing by seven. 8 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
You know, I think he's just trying to send his team a message, you know, not willing to give up on this game just yet. Just trying to instill that fight in this group.
No, it's like a Rubik's Cube. I feel like they've tried a lot of different things all night, but just haven't cracked the code yet. It's frustrating.
Unbelievable. This guy is completely in his own.
And so it's Sacramento who scraped by with the win. A narrow win under difficult circumstances.